Hello and welcome to the 3D quality inspection tools with Ruler3000 and SIM2x00 video in the SIGNOVA series. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can perform a quality check on milkshake packages. Let's verify the position of caps and read 2D codes, all in just a few simple steps. In the previous installation and image acquisition on Ruler3000 and SIM2x00 video, I've mounted and configured all components to capture great 3D images of my package. I recommend to watch this video before continuing. My laptop is connected to the Ethernet port 1 of the SIM2000 running the SIGNOVA sensor app. To access the user interface, open a web browser like Google Chrome and enter the default IP address 192.168.0.1. Let's capture a 3D image of a good sample, in my case a milkshake package with a correctly sealed cap and a well-printed QR code. Select Run as configured below the live image to capture new images when the trigger sensor has detected a package. Now run this package past the trigger and the camera. Looks great. To use this image as the basis to apply analysis tools on, click Update Reference below the live image. You will automatically switch to the Reference tab. Now I want to locate the package itself, in case its position varies. To do so, find the Analysis section on the left, select Add Tool, Locate, and then Object Locator. Move and adjust the tool region to include the entire package. To also reliably locate the package in case the cap is dislocated or missing, let's exclude it from the tool region. Find the Regions section on the right and select Add Region. Activate the Subtract checkbox and move and adjust the tool region to cover the inner area of the milkshake package. Now the localization is only based on the outer contour. To verify that the cap is correctly placed and tightened, let's measure the height and angle of the cap relative to the top surface of the package. Find the relevant planes on these features and, in a later step, measure the distance and angle between them. Add Analysis on the left, select Add Tool indented below Object Locator, choose Shape and then Plane Fitter. All indented tools are linked to the outdented tool above and follow its position. The plane fitter fits a plane on 3D data in the region of interest. This plane can be used as a reference for measurements in other tools. Move and resize the tool region to cover the flat package surface around the cap. Activate the background plane mode to only consider the bottommost 3D data points in the tool region. Switch to 3D view and rotate to a side view. I change to my preferred visualization. Hybrid mode, Lighting and automatic color range. As you can see, the calculated background plane does not really match the package surface. For the angled surface of my milkshake package, more than 15% of the bottommost 3D data points in the tool region are needed. For my application, around 50% works fine. For easier mapping, I recommend to rename the tool. Right-click on Plane Fitter, select Rename and change the name to Package Plane. Now let's fit a plane to the cap. Switch back to 2D view. Select Add Tool indented below Object Locator, choose Shape and then Plane Fitter. Change the tool shape to Ellipse and adjust the tool region to fit the cap. Rename the tool to Cap Plane. Switch to 3D view and verify that both planes are found correctly. As both planes are found, let's measure the distance between them. Add Analysis on the left, select Add Tool, choose Measure and then Distance. The Distance tool measures the distance between two features like points, lines or planes. In the settings on the right, change Feature A to Package Plane and Feature B to Cap Plane. Find the distance value in the results section. It states around 10 mm for my good sample. To use the measured distance as a pass-fail criteria, set the expected value to 10 mm and define the tolerance as 1 mm. To ensure that the cap surface and package surface are parallel, let's measure the angle between them. Add Analysis on the left, select Add Tool, choose Measure and then Angle. The angle tool measures the angle between two lines or planes. Change the reference feature to package plane and the secondary feature to cap plane. Find the angle value in the results section. It states around 0 degrees. To use the measured angle as a pass-fail criteria, keep the expected value at 0 degrees and define the tolerance as 2 degrees. Finally, I want to read the QR code printed on the cap using the intensity image of the Ruler3000. Add analysis on the left, select Add tool indented below object locator, choose Read, and then 2D code DPM. You will automatically switch to 2D view. This tool will read 2D codes in the tool region and output its content. Move and resize the tool region to cover the cap. In the settings section, change the code type to QR code. The results will now be displayed as an overlay next to the code and in the results sections on the right. In my case, the link to the SIGNOVA webpage. Now that everything is set up, let's verify that it works as expected. Switch to Live View and 3D View. Capture images of both good and bad packages and observe the results. When the cap is correctly positioned and the QR code is present, the overall result will report a pass. If the cap is missing, or not completely closed, or the QR code is missing, the overall result will report a fail. Amazing! Who would have thought 3D quality inspections of smaller and fast-moving objects could be this easy? If you can't wait to get started, get in touch with your local SIG sales representative now to find out more about the incredible world of SIGNOVA.